So you want to start with compare programming. Why? I believe that question is important to ask. I believe that once you ask yourself that question, you'll find it much easier to commit yourself. So ask yourself, why compare programming? Your answer probably lies amongst one of these two. The first one is that I want to get better at algorithms. I want to do well in contests because I enjoy programming and compare programming is what I like. The second one is that you have your interview scheduled and you need to get better at algorithms and data structures. The most efficient way that you find to do this is to compete with other human beings all around the world, and that is compare programming. So if you have one of these two goals, you've come to the right place. This channel is designed to talk about algorithms, data structures, coding practices, and computer science concepts so that you get a holistic view of what aptitude tests are. Compare programming is like a sport. It's a mind sport where instead of using your body, you're using your algorithms and you're using your coding practices to do well. The better you are at these two, the better you'll do in contests. Now, like in any sport, it does have some prerequisites and it also has some rules that you need to know about. Prerequisites for compare programming are, as you can guess, programming. You need to know about that, but since you've come here, I'm going to assume that you do know about it. And you need to know a little bit about algorithms. So that's what this channel is here for. So if you're here, again, that's taken care of. Now, what about the rules? In general, a programming contest goes this way. We participate in a contest. We choose a problem to solve. This problem will have its own input constraints. It'll also have its own input parameters. You need to give the specified output for this problem. After figuring out an algorithm to actually solve this problem, we make a submission to the online judge. And this submission may be either accepted or rejected. There's quite a few ways in which your submission can get rejected, but if it gets accepted, you get points. If you make the maximum number of successful submissions, you win the contest. And that's what compare programming basically is. Now, I am a young software developer. I learn things through different sources. And one thing that I try to do all the time is condense that information and make it as easily consumable by you guys. Why do I do it? Because I just enjoy it. You might be wondering, is compare programming really necessary? And the answer to that is no, it's not. You can still learn algorithms and data structures by yourself, but this is one of the most efficient ways in which you can do so. So if you want to give it a try, hit the subscribe button and I'll see you next time.